Are you curious how time blocking on Google Calendar can help you manage your busy life? In this video, I'm going to show you how to get started time blocking with Google Calendar and how moms can get more done by adopting this one habit. And stick around until the end because I'm sharing with you my favorite free productivity tool that works great with Google Calendar too. Welcome back to my channel. I'm Lauren Golden here with a new episode of Free Mama TV showing moms like you how to start and run a successful freelancing business from home. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified when I post a new episode of Free Mama TV right here every Tuesday. If you're thinking, I've totally heard of time blocking, but can you explain it to me again? I've got you. Time blocking is a type of scheduling that can help you manage your time better. Instead of bouncing from task to task without planning your day, time blocking is the process of arranging your tasks into the hours of a day to maximize your productivity, thus getting more done. It's a way to be in control of your schedule and plan your days in advance rather than sitting back and waiting for things to happen to you. So if you're a mom who is tired of feeling busy but not getting much done, or has a hard time focusing or finishing a task, listen up. I've saved countless hours and relieved stress by planning out my day. Here are my three quick tips to get started time blocking with Google Calendar. Tip number one, block time to time block. It takes some time on the front end to set up time blocking system using Google Calendar. So you'll want to carve out time to get it set up the right way. You'll need a free Gmail account or business G Suite account in order to access your Google Calendar. I find it easiest to set up via computer because you can see the big picture, but you can also do this from an app or on your phone. Personally, I have Google Calendar synced with my iPhone calendar on my cell phone as well. You're gonna start by inputting the things you do on a daily, weekly, or monthly basis. Maybe you have a weekly moms group or work meeting. Add in any appointments you're already aware of, or birthday parties, vacations. The reason we start here is because as we start to put in these non-negotiable appointments, we can start to block our time with our to-do list around the things that happen on a regular basis. Here's your pro tip. Decide early on if you'll use the same calendar for work and personal. I used to keep them separate, but found that seeing everything all at once made a lot more sense for my business, my team members, and my husband. Tip number two, block it out. Now it's time to look at your to-do list. Spend a moment thinking about all the things going on, the errands you need to run, the appointments you need to set, things you need to work on around the house, things you need to do at work or for your business, stuff for the kids. Get it all out on paper first so you can see it. Next, it's time to bring it over to your Google Calendar. Now, I wanted to show you what an actual week looks like for me so you can see how we start to build upon things that we know are happening. So back in step one, you put those weekly or daily or monthly recurrences. For us in the summertime, that means swim team. So first I get these blocks repeating so I can start to see what my days are actually going to look like. I also have a few weekly meetings. I have this call every week. I have this call every week. So they were already on there. And I start to build out appointments, both personal and professional around it. So I have a couple of fitness classes that I like to go to that are on here. I have some calls that other people have scheduled with me. For example, right here, I use an app called Calendly to allow other people to put themselves on my calendar at times that I pre-select that they can book with me. And as you can tell, I use color coding as well to distinguish between appointment time, work time, errand time, and then those family or personal things that we have going on. And then we just build around the different holes. So they're the things that happen every week. And then we drop time in between. So you can see right here, I literally blocked time so that nobody would fill that on my calendar. Now, what I will go in and do that week in terms of my time blocking is look at the things that I need to get done. Are there things still on my to-do list? Is there an errand I need to run? And then I will make sure that I utilize that time and I will know probably by the beginning of the week exactly what I will be filling that space with. Here's your pro tip. You're going to want to start paying attention to time. Without knowing how long it takes you to do certain tasks, you won't be able to time block as effectively. I have a question. I would love to know, do you time block already? What's working or not working for you? I'd love to hear your thoughts in the comments. Tip number three, start time blocking. You've prepped your Google Calendar, and now it's time to follow the schedule you've created for yourself. When a certain time block begins, it's important to eliminate other distractions so that you can focus on the task at hand. You planned for this. Every week, I pull up my Google Calendar just like this, typically on Sunday, sometimes not until Monday morning, but typically I like to go into the week knowing exactly what I have planned. Not only will I get a sense of what I need to accomplish that week and how much time I've set to do it, but as new things come up, I'll know what my availability is and I'll know if I need to reschedule. I frequently can be found saying things like, if it doesn't exist on my calendar, it just doesn't exist. So something for me, for example, is that Monday morning barbell strength class. Now, I like to leave it on there because I believe in prioritizing self-care. And if it's not on my Google Calendar, frankly, it doesn't exist. So I put it on there every week. But let's say I know that I have extra work I need to do or an errand, or I decide I want to spend that time taking my kids to the park. I will simply go in and either delete the event itself, or if it's something that it could exist at another time, unlike that class, but let's say I don't want to work on these emails at this time. I want to do it later in the day. The great thing about Google Calendar is you can literally pick it up and drop it off later so that you can move things with ease without having to cross anything off or remove it. And in fact, if something else came up that day, I could even shift it later to the week as well, no problem. Now that you have your Google Calendar set up, ready with things to do, both inside the house, outside the house, personal and work related, it's time to follow your calendar. The only way that time blocking can be an effective strategy is if when a certain time block begins, you focus on that thing that you are supposed to be doing during that designated time. Here's another pro tip. Don't overblock. When you schedule out your time blocks, it's important to keep windows in your day. Projects may come up that you weren't anticipating, and certain things may take longer to accomplish than you originally thought. The awesome part about Google Calendar is that it's easy to edit by dragging and dropping the edges of blocks so you can constantly update and stay on track. And now you know my three quick tips for getting started time blocking with Google Calendar. Now, if you struggle with managing your time, staying on track, or getting stuff done, you'll want to grab my productivity tool called the Daily Five. The Daily Five Productivity Planner is the exact tool I use to quit my job, start working from home, and spend more quality time with my kiddos. And it's been downloaded by tens of thousands of moms who are less stressed and less guilty. And now you can download it for free right now using the link below. Also, if you want to join a community of mamas just like you, I have a Facebook group where thousands of mamas come together for support and action-taking tips and motivation. If you liked this video, please let me know by liking it below, subscribe, and share it with your fellow mamas. And comment below with hashtag #IAmAFreeMama if this video helped you start time blocking with Google Calendar. That's what I get for not reading. Okay, sit in my chair like normal person. I don't know. Cats are being weird. Hours and revel. Revel is not confused. Blah, 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 blah. Okay.